knew we weren't going to a place near the coast of an ocean, and I was disappointed I wouldn't have another service on the beach. For the first 2 years, I had helped people who simply couldn't help themselves. One man was in a wheelchair, and his home had been destroyed by hurricanes, and one family's home needed to meet county requirements, but the family was physically unable to get on the roof. I was never very overwhelmed by what I saw in Mississippi or South Carolina, but I was completely unprepared for the magnitude of the poverty in Perry County, Kentucky. I discovered that I was helping this family, not because they were unable to help themselves, but because they were in a position that nearly prevented self-sufficiency. They were living in a home that was built into the side of a mountain. The runoff from the mountain was actually seeping into the underside of the home, which was one of the causes of the rotting floor joists. In the bathroom, the floor did not connect with the walls in several places, and the light oozed from the outside. The floor was extremely unlevel, and the walls were warped. It felt as if we were putting a big bandaid on this house, not fixing it. But how could it have been fixed? The water, over time, would eventually work its way back beneath the house. The linoleum would eventually curl, and the gaps between the floor and the walls would grow larger over time. To help depict how poor these people actually were, let me tell you an anecdote. On Wednesday afternoon, our third workday, as we were laying linoleum in the bathroom, our homeowner stood in the doorway and showed us what her neighbor had brought her from downhill. In her hands were three brown chicken eggs. She was as excited as I was on Christmas morning when I opened the package containing the iPod I'd asked for. She explained that she and her husband couldn't afford to keep chickens, so they'd been forced to sell them to maintain even a mediocre standard of living. They ate the eggs for lunch that day. They really had nothing. On Wednesday night, I had one more day to help the family to the best of my abilities. At the center, I wasn't feeling very well, so I went to the screened-in porch to cool down. I found myself thinking of so many things, about what I had to cram in for our last workday, about the magnitude of the job that would remain for the groups to follow, and about the family's faith in God, which was reflected in their optimism about the aid that we were giving them. In their eyes, we truly were there by God's grace. I sat on that porch for nearly 2 hours that night, crying and crying because I knew I couldn't help them as much as they deserved. By far, this mission trip has impacted me the most out of the three, and I still have one more to go. The bar has been set higher than I ever dreamed. The things I remember most from Mississippi and South Carolina are the beach services and the inside jokes I have with my friends. But the thing that I've taken from this trip is faithfulness. Faithfulness is the fruit of the spirit. Faithfulness is what gets the homeowners through each and every day. Faithfulness is what inspired the beautiful songs I sang for my work team during lunch. Faithfulness is what brought our church to serve their needs, and faithfulness is what inspires me to continue serving God.